We want to describe a function g of x in terms of f of x if the graph of g of x is obtained by vertically stretching the graph of f of x by a factor of 3, then shifting the graph left 2 units and down 4 units compared to the graph of f of x. So because g of x is a transformation of f of x, we can write g of x in this form here, where the values of a, b, c, and d transform the graph of f of x. And in our case, because we have a vertical stretch, we need to find the value of a. And then because we have a shift left 2 units, we have to determine the value of c. And because we have a shift downward 4 units, we need to find the value of d. So our function g of x will be in the form of g of x equals a times f of the quantity x plus c plus d. So let's review some notes on vertically stretching a graph, as well as shifting a graph left or right, or up or down. So for vertical stretches and compressions, we'll assume d is greater than 1. The graph of g of x equals d times f. The graph of g of x equals d times f of x is the graph of f of x stretched vertically by a factor of d. And since our graph is stretched vertically by a factor of 3, d is 3, meaning a is equal to 3. It's also true the graph of g of x equals 1 over d times f of x, but it's also true that g of x equals 1 over d times f of x is the graph of f of x vertically compressed by a factor of 1 over d. But in our case, we have d equal to 3 or a equal to 3. And then for our shift left, if a graph is shifted left or right, then the value of c is either positive or negative. If the value of c is negative or less than 0, the graph is shifted right c units. This is probably the opposite direction you might think. So if it's x minus c, it's right c units. And if c is positive or greater than 0, the graph is shifted left c units. So we'll have f of the quantity x plus c, which is the case for us. If our graph is shifted left c units, c will be positive 2. And our graph is also shifted down 4 units. If d is negative or less than 0, the graph is shifted down d units. So in our case, the graph is shifted down 4 units. So we'll have f of x minus d, or d is going to be negative 4. If d is positive, the graph is shifted up d units. So we'd have f of x plus d. So going back to our example, because it's stretched vertically by a factor of 3, a is equal to 3. And because our graph is shifted left 2 units, c is going to be positive 2. And because it shifted down 4 units, d is going to be negative 4. Which means g of x is equal to 3 times f of the quantity x plus c, or x plus 2. And then instead of plus negative 4, we'll write minus 4. This would be our function g of x. Now let's verify this by taking a look at the basic square root function and then changing the value of a to 3, c to 2, and d to negative 4 to see if it does transform the function in the way we expect. So here we're starting with the basic square root function. We'll first change a to 3, which should stretch it vertically by a factor of 3. Notice it is vertically stretching it. And then when a is equal to 3, we do have a vertical stretch by a factor of 3. We know this because the parent square root function would have the point 1, 1, or this point here. Notice how now when x is 1, the output is 3, 3 times as large. And now we said if c is positive 2, the graph will go left 2 units. So let's change c to positive 2. Notice how when c is positive, the function is moving left. So when the input is the quantity x plus 2, or c is positive 2, the graph has moved left 2 units. And now we'll change d to negative 4 to see if it goes down 4 units. Notice as we decrease d, or when d is negative, the graph is shifted down as we expected. So here's d equals negative 4. So our transformation is correct. I hope you found this helpful.